Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and it's a sensational scoop on Times Now, which will change the narrative in the mysterious Sushant Singh Rajput death case. Top CBI sources have revealed to Times Now how Sushant had literally dropped off the grid from 2:30 p.m. on 13th of June. That's exactly 22 hours before his body was found on the 14th of June at around 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Which is the whole mystery, because on the 13th of June, and based on hard facts in the form of call data records and WhatsApp chats recovered from the phone of Sushant Singh Rajput unlocked by the CBI, not a single message was read on Sushant's WhatsApp chats after 2:30 p.m. on 13th of June. No blue ticks on those messages before that had blue ticks on them, which means from 2:30 p.m. on 13th of June, Sushant Singh Rajput was not reading his messages. Was he alive? The last call that he received was from a talent manager at 2:22 p.m. on 13th of June. So why did Sushant go off the grid the day before his body was found? Was he silenced on the 13th June itself? That's the question many are asking. And this is the big mystery, along with the forensic report, which will help the CBI come to a conclusion on what charges and what is it that they are investigating, a suicide or a homicide. And joining me on the News Hour tonight is Tamal. Tamal? This is a huge investigation, and this information could turn the entire investigation on its head. So far, we are talking about an abetment to suicide case. What if Sushant Singh Rajput was gone on the 13th of June, and we know that the post-mortem report had no time mentioned on it of the death of Sushant Singh Rajput?
Well, Navika, as far as Neeraj, Dipesh, Siddharth Pithani and Keshav are concerned, four people who were there inside the house of Sushant Singh Rajput on 14th of June, when Sushant Singh Rajput's body was found under mysterious circumstances and recovered, all these four people, quite surprisingly, have given out different timing of they having seen Sushant Singh Rajput for the last time. For example, Neeraj, in his testimony to CBI, has suggested the last time he saw Sushant Singh Rajput was at 8 in the morning, wherein Siddharth Pithani has suggested that he saw Sushant Singh Rajput sometime between 8:30 and 9 o'clock. Likewise, Keshav too has given out a different timing. So for CBI, it is quite evident that all these four people are possibly not giving out the true picture, or there is something amiss. So at this point in time, this revelation coming to the forefront, information access by Times Now clearly suggests that Sushant Singh Rajput fell off the grid at 2:30 p.m. on June 13. Thereafter, as far as digital footprints are concerned, be it social media or WhatsApp, there had been no transaction of communication, no transaction of information, no touch base with anybody whatsoever.
Well, and there are discrepancies in the versions given. The cook says juice was given to Sushant Singh Rajput on the morning of 14th. And then there was a call made by Dipesh Sawant to somebody who was contacting Sushant for an advertisement campaign. The question is, was Sushant Singh even alive, or were alibis being created? Because there is the testimony of the key maker. There is the testimony of the neighbor. The neighbor who said the lights went off early, the key maker who said that he was first shunted out before the door was opened. And that really leads us to question, did those at home already know that Sushant was gone? Which is why they were wanting to keep this hidden from the key maker. And Siddharth Pithani's statements clearly leave a lot of questions that haven't been answered. Well, That's the big breaking news. We'll string all of these together, and we are awaiting for the medical board of the All India Institute of Medical Sciences to meet on the 17th of September, and then we will know whether this is not at all a suicide that we are looking at, and in fact, it could be homicide and foul play. We'll keep following this story, but ladies and gentlemen, the other big development today is the 3 months that we've seen the Galwan standoff going on at the line of actual control. China continues its aggressive posturing along the border, but India is not one to back down. And that's the message Defense Minister Rajnath Singh gave today to the entire country from Parliament. Silencing the doubters' lobby, the Defense Minister Rajnath Singh said that our forces gave a befitting reply to the PLA troops for their misadventure and that India is prepared for all eventualities. Meanwhile, Times Now is reporting exclusively from the frontiers. At the last post, along the line of actual control, from troop deployment to logistical backups, India is leaving no stone unturned to ensure that any possible Chinese misadventure will be answered back. Take a look at the Defense Minister and our heroes in action.
बहादुर जवान अत्यंत मुश्किल परिस्थितियों में अपने अथक प्रयास से समस्त देशवासियों को सुरक्षित रख रहे हैं। एक ओर किसी को भी हमारे सीमा की सुरक्षा के प्रति हमारे डिटर्मिनेशन के बारे में संदेह नहीं होना चाहिए। वहीं भारत यह भी मानता है कि पड़ोसियों के साथ शांतिपूर्ण संबंधों के लिए आपसी सम्मान और आपसी सेंसिटिविटी भी आवश्यक है। क्योंकि हम मौजूदा स्थिति का डायलॉग के जरिए समाधान चाहते हैं और हमने चाइनीज साइड के साथ डिप्लोमेटिक और मिलिट्री एंगेजमेंट बनाए रखा है।
As we are at a forward location here, you can see this is how the fighter jets are taking out sorties. This is basically a backup to the personnel who are at the forefront here. You can see in the visuals, this is the Indian Air Force aircraft that has just taken off from a forward air base. And it's basically giving backup to the personnel. Indian Air Force fighter jets are continuously taking out sorties across Ladakh region as there is face-off going on along the LAC.